Right. Finally, here we go. Going through it in book order, and they want to start with the tail assembly or the empennage, whatever you call it. I've jumped the gun a little bit. I've got the plan pinned down with drawing pins, and I've got some cooking saran wrap, I think it's called, a clear plastic wrap over the plan. The only reason we do this really is to stop the glue sticking to the plan. The glue will stick to the saran wrap, but that's not quite so bad. Ideally, what I would normally do if it was me building from a plan would be to cut out each piece and from the plan stick it down and carry on as we are. But because really I'm going from a beginner's point of view, we're not going to do anything really advanced like cutting the plan up. If you do build from a plan and you want to cut the plan up, take it down to your local print shop and get them to do a one-to-one. It'll cost, in this country, for the average plan, about £8 to £10. Probably the same amount in dollars or wherever you are, euros. And you'll have to excuse the whirring noises in the background, if you can hear them. I've got my heater on, it's a cold day. We've got wind and rain and all sorts going on outside there. Anyway, 1:40 and I haven't done anything. So, let me bring the tail, the book into here. You can see it says tail assembly, and hopefully you can read some of this. If not, first thing, set your flat warp-free pinning board on workbench. Oh, we've done that. Tape Eagle plan to stabilizer, or sew the stabilizer into in position over the pinning board. I have too many tongues in my mouth today. Tape a sheet of wax paper or plastic kitchen wrap over stab area to prevent glue sticking to the plan. Okay. And now we need this. And if you go back a page, all the parts are laid out here that you get in the box. So we need this. It's got the rudder, the fins, stabilizer, leading and trailing edge joiner, center platform, and the stabilizer tips. And it's sheet number 5604. And if you look at this, can I get it up there? It's 5604. Beautifully cut, laser cut. Parts just drop right out. So I've already pushed out and pinned down the center section here, and we've got already pushed out and pinned down the leading edge joiner and the training edge joiner. Now let's just pop that to one side. Whoop, see, they're that well thought out that they just fall out. Also, we've got the wing tips like so. Now these parts are made up out of half by quarter, so we have to cut those to size. And here, I'll hold this up so you can see it, is the elevator. Okay, now taking your very fine sandpaper, what you need to do is gently sand off like that. You don't take all the burn marks off, but you just take it down so it's smooth. And you're gluing both sides of this, so just gently rub it, and that will allow it to stick. Give it a quick blow, and same with this one. There we go. Done it a little bit more than this really already, but you get the basic idea. Put that down. Now, these lay over the plan exactly as per. That one goes there, and that one goes there. Okie doke. These are already pinned down. My board is quite hard. It's quite difficult to do this. Now, I'm just reaching back and getting a pen. If you just very carefully, a little bit of, I use a ballpoint pen on balsa. Excuse my head. You need to get the tip, the pointy bit, level with the centre line. Just mark that like that. Why am I doing this, you say? Because here comes the zapper gap. We really don't want much glue on this. This stuff is quite amazing. And here we go. There we are. Just wiggle this about a bit. And between the little lines you marked, just a little glue. You really don't need bucketfuls. Can you see that? And check its level. Check its central. Push it up to that. And pop a pin in it. No good like that. Do you know what I'm going to do? I'm not going to pin them. I'm actually going to just put that in there like that. Okay? And now I'll turn this over so I can see my marks. Just a little bit of glue. You do not want a lot of this stuff. This is where it comes out in a great flood. There we go, if you can see that. Okay. Well, I can see it, so presumably it's all right. There we are. And push that on there, like that. Reach over, get a pin. Pin in there. Pin in there. This is quite hard balsa. I mean, this is still not entirely solid in here, is it? We want to get this so it stays there. There we go. That's better. Okay, now we do. Now we need that one and that one. I haven't yet tidied this one up. You can see how dark they are. There we are. And using the smooth end of my permagrit, just gently. You really don't need to do this hard. Just gently. Make sure you're flat on the surface. There we go. One of those goes there. Now these guys here, again, really gently. Now, we want to do our talk through this, shouldn't I? Here we go. Line it up. Zonk it off. Can you see this? Yes, you can. I'm trying to get better at this video business. Not looking for sympathy. Now just push it up to your mark. Always cut on the outside of your marks. Always take a little bit more off, but it's quite difficult to put it back on again. Now you've got a nice 90 degree line there. Okay, we put that there and put that up to the line. Yes, that fits, and that fits. Okay, all right. So, again, just a little mark there, and a little mark there, and a little bit of sticky goop. And you check the ends are on the lines. Yes, they are. And there. You go. And now you can see why I was talking in the last video about glass-headed pens. Not the best idea. Bear with me, I'm just going to take the mic off. I'm going to get a couple of clamps. We're that well organized. Okay, we're back. Now, something isn't quite straight here. And these are a bit fierce, these clamps. But that's on there. And that went on there. There we go. Yes. Excuse me. Right. Now here is where we need to be careful, because we have to cut this into two. So the easiest way to do that is to put it roughly central there. I'm going to be smack on. And find where you've put your pen. Is it me, or does this happen to everybody? I had a pen here a minute ago, and now it's gone walkies. Yep, totally disappeared. Oh well. And also I've discovered I'm not following the book. Follow the book. Oh yeah, we're doing all right. We're doing okay. That is, where have we got here? I've stuck the trailing edge on. And the book is being followed. There we are, it's in the usual easy to find places. Little mark on that. Lap it in half. Let me see what I'm doing, because I can't see what I'm doing. Okay, excuse me just a minute while we do this. Right. we've got to take that V out of there. Easiest way to do that is with the rough end. Put a rough. There we are. Just a little bit more. I'm not doing this on camera, am I? Dear, oh dear, oh dear. That's it. Smack on. Now, take the other end. You can hold your hand like that, it won't hurt your finger. And just a slight angle. Give it a blow. And how far away is it? Not very. Okay. I think just a tad more, actually. Because it's not meeting at the top. There we go. Okay. Now you see there's the line on the plan. You get that on the line and you're away. Now what we need to do. This stuck one wonders. Yeah, it's sticking. It's pretty good. Excuse me. While this sits there, hold that smack on there, follow the line, finger on it, and the pen. The magic pen is over here. There, like that. Okay, excellent. And we do the same this side. There we go. And just a mark with a pen. Now, because it sits like this, and the tips are straight, like that, these aren't straight. They're on an angle compared to that. They are not, what's the word, perpendicular, is it? Yeah, I think so. It's a nice word anyway, perpendicular. Right, so I'm going to go and saw these off camera. Bear with me. Sawing as we think about it. I've got to hold them at an angle. Clean it up. There we go. Pop it back there in the middle. Hold it down with fingers and put the tip on. It's ready to line the back up, isn't it? And boom. Yes, that's good. That's good. It actually needs to be just a little bit off there. Okay. What does that look like? That looked brilliant. I'll do the other one. I'm going to do is saw it at a slight angle. I'll be right back. I'm sure I'm going to have to go for a pee with this mic clipped on. Right, here we go. And once more, now we're back. There we go. Okay, now I'm going to check something here. Are these both exactly the same size? Yes, they are. Which means that the good old plan, right, that's pretty good. Now, what we're going to do at this point, use this. Why, you say? Because it's actually a teeny weeny bit stronger, believe it or not. There we go. Just a couple of little marks on there. This stuff is actually stronger than... Oh dear, oh dear, oh dear. Do not get on fingers. And I put a bit on the end there. See how it grabs? Grabs really well. A little touch on there. And run a bit down here. Dear, oh dear. I'm not getting any less. Always have tissues around when you're doing this. Excuse me. No, it's not looking bad. It's not looking bad. Here we go. We'll pop that up there. Yeah, it'll be alright. Pins. Big pins. Big pins and little pins. Okay. This isn't going into the bench. This is going into the other piece of wood. And this then can go into the bench. Like that. And this. There we go. And stop it warping, bending, and otherwise playing silly buggers. There we are. Good. You notice I haven't been putting the little marks on these. It's because, well, there we go. pins. Ah, you can imagine, can you not? The pain, the agony, and the ecstasy of one of those glass-headed pins breaking and going through your finger. Oh boy, oh boy. Can you just? Yeah, that's fine. Now, put a couple of pins in here. Too great an angle. Oh my. That's better. Now we need to keep this up against. So if you put a pin in at an angle like that, start it off and then pull it up, give it a bit more. You see it squeezing out? And we need another big one. Here we are. You can't do this brutality with the little pins. So you push it in at an angle, right in front thereof, pull it up, squeeze it in. And Bob's your uncle. Okay. You get this off with the damp cloth, but it'll be all right as it is. There we go. Where's the tissue? Here's the family tissue. Been in the family for several years now. Saying much, I know, but I think it's pretty obvious what we're doing. We do that again, and we push that in there, and push it up, and push it in. And push that in there like that. Straighten it up, push it down, and that keeps it tucked in. Lovely. Okay, everybody's on the line. Excuse my head. It's not quite straight, which is the brilliant part of this glue. It does give you a few moments of messing about time. Not a lot. Right. Now I think that'll do for this video. And when we come back, we'll be putting the fillers in, or the ribs, and cutting this to size. Because as you can see, and also something to notice is that it only goes one way. Let me just see if I can get this. There. You see the gap? Turn it over the other way. And gapless, or more or less. There we are. And that's the elevator. That'll go like that when it's all done. Yes, well. Right. This all needs another couple of hours to dry, and I can pop this video onto YouTube and make everybody absolutely 100% certain that they're sorry they ever watched it. Nah, I hope not. Always put the tops on your glue when you're done. I've done that one. There we go. Let's take this away from any possible glue. And leave that for at least an hour, and it will become, yes, if I had some thin zap or any other CA glue, what you can do, once you've glued it up with the white glue, you can just put a couple of little dabs of thin CA and that will set, and it'll save all the pins and the clamps. A couple of little dabs. It's amazing. It will work together with it. In the meantime, we'll just leave this the way it is. And when we come back, we'll be putting in, I've got to find it in the box first, the 8x1/4 to do these. There we go. But if you see, we're up to this point now. Where are we? Put that up to you. There. That's where we are. So, next job is to do this one. So we'll be on step number 3, or even 4. Okay? Wiggly thumbs. I think somebody else does wiggly thumbs. I'm not going to do it. I just did it. Oh, shut up. Right, thank you for watching. And here's my remote control for the camera. And we'll zoom in a little tiny bit. No, we won't. Yes, we will. Look at that. Oh, the miracles of modern technology. Goodness me. Right. You can see the pin better there. I'm just wasting everybody's time now. Thank you for watching. Please leave comments. I really do value comments and opinions. I'm not the arbiter of how to build these. I just build them the way I build them. So if you've got a better idea, or if you want to share something, please, please, please leave it in the comments. I don't know whether it's good, bad or indifferent. I really don't mind. Thumbs up and subscriptions would be nice, but comments are even better. Thank you very much indeed, and we'll see you next video.